If Democrats Kamala Harris and Governor Tim Walz win the election next week, that would create a major shift in leadership in state government.
Right. If that were to happen, then Minnesota would have a new governor, a new lieutenant governor as well. Eric Shalhoub continues our countdown to Election Day coverage live from the state capitol. Eric?
Hey, Leah and Paul, the Minnesota Constitution makes it clear if the governor were to resign or leave office, the lieutenant governor would move up. Now, that's happened more than a half dozen times here at the state capitol in the history of Minnesota. Now, this time around, Peggy Flanagan could, if this all happens, make history, not only in the state and country, by moving up to the governor's office.
Of the United States, Tim Walz.
If the Kamala Harris-Tim Walz ticket wins the White House, the governor would then have to resign from his Minnesota office.
It is my intention to represent the people of Minnesota.
Back in 1976, Governor Wendell Anderson appointed himself to replace Walter Mondale in the U.S. Senate.
And no one could assume the duties of governor under better conditions.
Which made way for Lieutenant Governor Rudy Perpich to take over. Seven times in state history, a lieutenant governor has moved up to the governor's office for a variety of reasons.
I feel like we've laid a really strong foundation for whatever comes next.
Good morning.
It would be an historic move for Lieutenant Governor Peggy Flanagan to become governor. The former State House member, Minneapolis school board member, and DFL organizer would become the first female governor in state history. Flanagan says she's been at the table with Walz on key decisions.
We put our budgets together, our policy priorities, literally sit side by side at the head of the table in the cabinet room. And so, I have learned an incredible amount from him.
As a member of the White Earth Nation, Flanagan would also become the country's first indigenous woman to serve as governor.
House File 28 is affectionately known as...
It was unprecedented because we had never had a person of color or a black person to step up and be elected president. So I, count that as an honor.
State Senate President Bobby Joe Champion, an attorney, former Minneapolis House member, and father from Minneapolis, could be elevated to lieutenant governor.
What I would bring is perspective, balance, a desire to, make sure all of our lives are improved. And I think that's really an important quality.
State law says it is whoever is the last elected Senate president that would then move up to the lieutenant governor's role. Again, this is all dependent on what happens with Walz in the election next week. We've got much more on the history of lieutenant governors moving into the governor's office on our website at KSTP.com. We're live tonight here at the state capitol in St. Paul. Eric Shalhoub, 5 Eyewitness News.